out. Okay, it's just Tai Chi in a nutshell for you are in these pamphlets, so pick up one of these. And before I start, let's spread the energy around, not only to this room. Let the energy flow down to the streets of Mumbai, across the oceans, across the sea, and maybe to the other end of the world. So as I offer you this energy, please pass it on. Namaste. Namaste. So friends, you see, Tai Chi, Qigong, Shibashi, I have explained plenty of times, Tai Chi, Qigong. Let's come to this part, Shibashi, or as the Chinese pronunciation is, Shibazi. Shibazi is nothing but the figure 18. It means 18 movements of Tai Chi and Qigong combined. Very graciously, somebody who is an expert in Tai Chi, Qigong, Shibashi is present here with us today. I will introduce you to him. Very amazing personality, and when it comes to introducing him to people, I always say that he walks his talk. Before going on, let me again give you a tip on Tai Chi and Qigong. Always remember one thing: where the mind goes, the energy flows. So if your mind is here, the energy flows. If your mind goes outside to the streets of Fort and VT, the energy will flow out to Fort and VT, and you are going to be deprived of it. Okay, so today, taking this opportunity and saying, if I'm going to get an expert visit us and talk to us and also get us to do some of Tai Chi, Qigong, Shibashi, I decided, let me for once sit with the audience and also enjoy being trained by somebody else. So my dear friends, let me introduce you to Mr. Sunil Saman. Sir, please. Mr. Sunil Samant is now for the past 15 to 16 years specializing in Tai Chi, especially in Tai Chi, Qigong, Shibashi. Sunil Samant is an international certified instructor for Tai Chi, Qigong and Shibashi. I won't say more, but I will hand over this mic to Sunil Samant. Sir, all yours.
Thank you. Carlton sir, and all the participants of this program. How much time we have? About an hour? Half and half? Okay, fine. Yeah. So I will pace my. Okay, excellent, excellent. Fine. Sir has already briefed you about what Shibashi is. I will give you a little more inner core, how the development of the Shibashi took place. All right. As you know, you are, I think, followers, all of them are followers of Tai Chi. Okay, you are aware of what different forms are involved into it. And some of the established renowned forms are Chen style, Yang style, Sun style, Wu style, you know, and there are many things. And there was a genuine problem. As we know, in you know, people who sing, you know, they have all those gharanas, you know, gharanas like Gwalior gharana, and you know, there are various gharanas. And there are followers and there are teachers. Now, similarly, Tai Chi has certain gharanas, all right? And then every gharana wants to establish, okay, I am the superior, sing my song. I am the superior, sing my song, and things like that. A common man like you and me was getting confused. Which one should I follow? Because it's a question of my health, my liking, and my practice, and my enjoyment. Now, which one should I follow? If I start following chain style, and then I want to learn young style, and then the person will say, no, you are a chain follower, follow chain, okay, you know, things like that. So there was a lot of confusion, and people still wanted to learn Tai Chi because, let's say, after the curtain was opened by China, lot of information started coming out. Now, the development of this form called Shibashi, which consists of 18 movements, is developed by a professor, a teaching professor and a doctor in China University by name Lin Haosheng. Okay? And he picked up, what he did was, he picked up some of the best movements from different gharanas, from different styles and things like that. So people who are practicing, let's say, Yang style, suddenly they will find there are good movements in Shibashi. You know, some good movements are picked up from Yang style, some from Yisan style, and some from... Now, instead of going in a continuous form, what he devised is certain movements to be repeated. Repeated 6 times, repeated 8 times, and things like that. And this was done somewhere in 1979-80. I was in Hong Kong during 80s, you know, for my business visit. I'm primarily an engineer with IT background. I worked for IBM for long time. I was associated with IBM, Compaq, Microsoft and whatnot, name all those IT companies. But eventually I thought, let me give some of my life and time for understanding this beautiful art which I saw when probably I was 30 plus. And I didn't think that it might be useful for me at a later date of my life, later time, okay. I started practicing this, learning this. Not much of material or anything was available, but eventually a group in Canada assisted me in putting my hands, you know, on the material and on the form way back, and it was quite useful. I started learning on my own, and then over a period of say 3 to 4 years, I started realizing how dynamically it is giving me an opportunity to transform myself, you know, into a different personality or different trait and things like that, okay. Thereafter I said, let me start sharing with others also. So I started, you know, sort of meeting people and conducting some kind of workshops and things, and then, you know, developed some methodology to teach such things, okay. As far as my involvement with Shibashi is concerned, is, you know, this is the general background. 2009 I visited Australia. I met the grandmaster who is expert in Shibashi, and I showed my skill sets to him. I did not learn anything from him, but I said, look, I have learned on my own, but I would like to show my skill set not as a practitioner but as a trainer also. So if you approve this, maybe you can certify. and to my delight, I was certified by them. So I am a certified Shibashi trainer, you know, by Australian Academy of Tai Chi. Australian Academy of Tai Chi has a very large organization in Australia, having something like about maybe 200 centers and maybe 2,000 trainers like me in Australia alone. Okay, and we were fortunate to hire the grandmaster about 3 years back. He is very again keen to come here to India. Name is Mr. Gary Kaur. All right. Now, after summing this, I would like to now brief you on this portion. Now, the 18 movements that Sir has talked about, it is a form, okay. So instead of like in typical Yang style movements, there are say, let's say 24 movements, and we do one after the other, and there is a definite transformation from one to another, thing like that. Here there is a transformation, but each movement is repeated 8 times, okay. And It has got certain postures, it has got certain meaning, and it has got certain nomenclature also. I mean, each moment is been named by let's say some movement of the bird or movement of animal and or something like that. Okay, we'll go through that subsequently. In learning, I think that will be better because I think that echo is. Is this okay? Okay, all right. Okay. Oh, this is comfortable. My both hands are free. I am happy. Good. When we learn Tai Chi, Qigong, I'm sure you know there are sir must have addressed you in various stages and methods. How one go about it? Okay. I would like to share some interesting aspect of this learning, how Shibashi process goes, the learning of Shibashi process goes. So initially what we have is called as form. Okay, the form consists of certain movements. There are 18 movements. Okay, each movement is repeated 8 times. All right. Now how one can go about to learn these movements. Ideally, let's pick up only one movement, let's say, okay, and then see how things can work on that. Okay. Then once you learn that movement, you practice that movement. Now it might be one movement, it might be two movements, it might be 3 movements. Depends on you, your pace, your comfort zone, and your understanding that fine, I can in a session of say about half an hour, 45 minutes, 1 hour, I can learn only one moment or 2 moments or 3 moments. I have seen people who can pick up 6 moments, but they are much younger, the brain is fresh. Okay, we would like to go with our pace and our age and our, you know, adaptability, whereby whatever we do in half an hour or 1 hour, you know, we try to correlate, we try to understand what is the name of that moment, okay, and then when we go back home, we try to remember, okay, this is the way the moment was done. So we practice that moment over a period of 1 week regularly, at least for 10 minutes or 15 minutes, okay, by which without fail we go into what we call as a Tai Chi mode. You know, we go into Tai Chi mode maybe early morning or late evening or whenever it is convenient, depending upon profession, time availability and everything. All right. So Tai Chi mode is very important. In medical terms, sometimes we say that, you know, he is not well, you give him a tranquilizer. You know, there's a common term, tranquilizer. You know, some kind of a tablet whereby the person goes quiet, you know, tranquilizer. So the first stage, the moment you want to start practicing or learning Tai Chi, the first stage is called tranquility. Okay, if you want, you know, you can make a note of it. Very, very, very interesting concept. So you have to go into tranquility, by which it starts bringing your right brain to help you and start assisting you in what they call as a healing process. Okay, you must have talked about healing, various methods and things like that. The left brain is responsible for taking conscious decisions, whereas the right brain is responsible to carry out the unconscious, unknown activities. Okay, so we have to go into that tranquility mode. All right, and then thereafter, once you are in the tranquility mode, that is, you know, now I want to do Tai Chi. How do I start? Okay, the next one is called relaxation. So first one is tranquility. It has been done what they call as by a particular stance, what we call Bhuji stance. Now what is a Bhuji stance? You stand like this, which is our conventional posture, and then you just, you know, spread your legs, stand evenly, balance, with proper balance on both legs, all right? Okay, and your legs should be parallel. They are not like this or like this, okay? But eventually the distance between the two legs is so much that it is up to shoulder width, so that you are perfectly balanced in that position, okay? That gives you a status of tranquility. Like, you know, moment we come in, you know, we just bow down and wish each other, okay? It triggers that now you are in Tai Chi mode. You are on receiving mode, okay? Normally on Churchgate station or VT station, nobody will bow and, you know, this thing. Something like that we will do like this. But when you come for Tai Chi, the convention is like this or like this. Whatever way, you know, you have been taught. Now there will be again, you know, there will be difference between one master to another master. Don't get hassled, you know. Eventually when you learn Tai Chi, someday you will become master. And then you have your own form. Keep that in mind, you know. And that is how you start enjoying, you know, Tai Chi. Alright? So the next is called as relaxation. Now you are in this form, then you start relaxing. Like you sink slightly, you know, bend your knees slightly, your hands are virtually hanging, okay? There is no stress or tension in shoulder area here. Your eyesight is upright here, just like this, you know. Keep a distance of say mid-level. Don't look at long distance or don't look at short distance. Now when you look at long distance, there is a chances, you know, you will start looking like this. When you are looking at short distance, your focus will go down. Keep mid-distance, alright? Stand like this, and this is virtually in a relaxed mode. There are movements for your jaws and movements for your tongue and everything, you know, the positions I would say, rather than movements. So your tongue, if possible, keep it against your back of the top T row, okay? Keep a gap, slight gap between the teeth, and keep your lips closed and breathe normally. So this is called relaxation. Now with the practice, slowly, you know, you will understand and realize what are the benefits of standing in this posture. There are people who can stand in this posture for hours and hours, you know, and there is another method, you know, just like this. And listening to the music of nature, the birds and the river and the sea, and you know, enjoying the breeze, but they are virtually standing in this posture like this. Alright? Okay. So next is relaxation. The third one is called dilation. The dilation is a very interesting. You must have heard the method of dialysis in people who undergo extremities of kidney failure. They require a dialysis. What do? They inflate, you know, the veins, and then remove the toxic and inject fresh blood. Now that process occurs in our body. Once you start doing Tai Chi, dilation, okay, the meridians expanded, you know, the controlling points get expanded, and they clean the path, you know, for effectively transportation of qi, which is the next stage. Transportation is the next, okay? So first one is tranquility, second one is relaxation, third one is dilation, okay? Now you are ready to move the qi. Okay? And the form is started. You start doing the form. The qi is generated, okay? And then you are transporting the qi, as he said, by taking our mind, which is following the movement. The mind follows the movement, the qi follows the mind. Okay? So the fourth stage is transportation. Then comes called as absorption. Absorption. Now you go to such a stage that not only the qi you generate, gets transported to specific points where it is required most, but also through porosity on your body, you start receiving chi from the universe. The basic controlling points of the chi are your palm, foot, and top of the head. Okay, these three where all the controlling meridians points are. Okay, so which are responsible for connecting the bridges for transportation. Okay, absorption is the next process, and once absorption takes place, the last stage is called release. Whatever is excess, you release by grounding the chi. Okay, so six stages, remember that. I mean, it just is a simple to thing. Now these six stages are being observed while we do Tai Chi, Qigong, Shibashi. Okay. Shall we have some orientation now? So you kindly get up. Put the chairs sideways. This, you take your right fist, put it here, alright, and bow. Right. Now lift your left leg and put the side about shoulder width. Okay. Will you feel comfortable if you remove the sandals? Because otherwise,
yeah, those who are standing with very high
heel sandals, please avoid them. Should not hurt your. Okay. Now, simple correction. See here how she is standing. You know, because of your this thing, you know, you end up in standing like this. Instead of that, let it come parallel. You have some problem. Okay, correct. Parallel. See, just look at me. For example, you know, this is a plank here and this is a plank here, and I am making use of the plank. Okay, alright, I am standing like this. Alright, have you understood the position, the exact standing posture? Now once you put your leg like this and shoulder width apart, you should feel comfortable. Most important, because you cannot go into tranquility if you are uncomfortable. Alright, so you had to be very, very comfortable. Okay, like this. Then sink your, you bend your knees and do a slight sink very slowly. Those who can't sink, can't bend the knees, don't do it deliberately. Okay, just observe it, because for them there are different methods. Okay, you can do these things even by sitting in chair also. Okay, I'll show you that. All right so like this. Now how do we stand, to what extent we can stand? Okay, the guideline is the knee should come in line with your tip of the toe. Like when you see like this, the tip of the toe should be visible. Now don't go excessively. Okay, on the contrary, even if you sink slightly within your threshold, that's much better. If you can't sink, don't sink. Okay, if you can't sink, don't sink. All right sir, please stand up. Excellent, you can do that very well. All right so sinking like this. Now I will just go sideways. Okay, now there are chances, because we don't sink regularly, there are chances that we might end up in doing like this, or we might end up in doing like this. Okay, don't do this. Both the movements are harmful. Okay, both the postures are harmful. So that's the reason, if we can sink properly, just slightly like this, okay? Okay, all right, just to keep balance, you know, just see, yes, I'm straight now, okay? Probably you can see in the mirror, you know, when you practice, and then you will know exactly whether you are doing correctly or not. So that is what we call as Vuji stance, called Vuji, W-E-J-I, Vuji stance. So we are standing like this, okay? The hands absolutely free. As I mentioned earlier, like Devanand. You know, Devanand hands were, they were, never had any stress or tension in the hands. He could prolong for 88 years. You know, always used to move like this. So, right? So, hands very loose. No stress in this area, no stress in this area, okay? Your tongue touching the back of your top teeth row, okay? Lips, yeah, zipped. As and when you practice, you know, you will find this will start giving you that position of what we call as a tranquility. You know, you are virtually going in the Tai Chi mode, slowly, steadily, as and when you practice. Now, for people who can't, those who can't bend easily, okay, you can always do this by just putting your hands here as a secondary support and then just sink like this. Okay, this is a secondary support, you know, that eventually at certain age, certain distance, either because of specific problems in legs or because of aging, the stamina, the strength is not there, so we require some kind of a confidence, so less, okay, you just put your hands here. This is quite useful, especially for the people who had strokes earlier, you know, the strokes problem, where they have no control on their hands and legs and things like that. But when they have the support, just a touch, you know, they can stand in this posture for some time. All right, if the chair is not available, you can take the support of this, or you can take the support of even the window pane. You know, there are old buildings, you know, in the window, there are window panes. Just put your hands on the window pane and just sit like that, okay? Practice this regularly, you know, to see how long you can stand. 30 seconds, 40 seconds, 50 seconds. Start little bit with 10 seconds to begin with, and then go on in increasing that. The more you stand in that posture, you are achieving the tranquility will be faster. Once you are in the tranquil mode, you know, Tai Chi mode, then you will learn the technique of relaxation, because your entire weight is been now, you know, transferred. Your upper body doesn't feel any weight at all. You know, you virtually become weightless, kind of thing, like this. Okay? All right, good. So this is called Vuju stance. Shall we go to the movement part?
Yes, yes, yes.
Okay,
please,
fine,
please,
fine, fine, fine. Right. Now, the first movement in Qigong, Shibashi, the Shibashi first set is called raising the arms. Okay? The name itself will give you an indication what we are supposed to do. Alright, so we are in the Vuji stance, like this, You are rising. Okay. Start raising your hands up to here. Alright. Now let the hand be pointing towards the floor. Okay. There is a natural bend here. Maintain that bend. Don't interlock. Don't stretch like this. Let it be like this. Very loose. Okay. Move your hand like this. Bring it here. And then sink down. Again up. Back. And down. Again up. Back. And down. Up. Back. And down. Right, withdraw, up, back, down. Do it very slowly, up, back, and down, up, back. You don't have much of space there to breathing later on. Breathing is later on. I am coming down to that. Okay. Like this. Back and down. Up. Back and down. I will just go sideways so that you can see laterally how the movement looks. Okay. Up. Up, down, up, up. All right. Don't you think it's easy to do this? This we have done during our school days, college days, you know, what we call as the morning exercises, part of this thing. But here it is being done very slowly, and when you do slowly, you understand the different postures. See here, how many limbs are moving. First, we are sinking down, so our knee joints and other joints are working. Okay, then we are raising our hand. Raising hand, this joint is working. Okay, then this joint is working. Alright, then we move like this, it comes here. So this joint is also working. Alright, then we sink down. This joint is working. So simultaneously, there are multiple, you know, joints which are being exercised slowly, gently with this movement. Just as a matter of curiosity or interest, if you are sitting in a chair, maybe at the beach or in the house or anywhere, just put one side, you know, one hand just aside and start moving your hand just like this. See how soothing effect that can give you. Slowly and steadily. Don't count. Just keep on doing it at home. Okay? And just see how soothing effect can give you. Especially, you know, if you are reading something, we are watching TV or something like that, we are in a particular posture for half an hour, 1 hour, and suddenly we find that, we can't get up. There is a catch here. My hand is not moving. Thing like that. Especially when you are likely to be in that posture, one common posture for a long duration, suddenly you are watching a TV, fine, but just keep on moving your hand. It allows you for very good blood circulation, okay, and doesn't give you any kind of spasm, you know, while you are observing, and you enjoy. When you are in a, your blood circulation is proper, there are no pains, you know, you enjoy whatever you are doing to a very great extent. Alright, so this movement is called raising the arms. Okay. Shall we go to the next?
Yes.
Okay, excellent. Now, I don't know whether you have, you don't have, you don't have much of space actually. So what you are doing is, you are moving your hand in this fashion. It has to go like this. Most important, apan jayche kasa, step by step. Tamale shakyato visrayachi sandhi dyaychi nahi. Okay, we are not overeating by which we don't allow the systems for indigestion. All right. So I'll just stand in a angular fashion. Comfortable, no problem. All right, like this. Now, in the first moment, what we did was raised our hands and then we sank down. All right. Now this position is called home position. Home position, and this is the closing movement or position after the first movement. The next movement begins with this, and you start raising your hands like this and just open out. Just open out. Open your arms like this. Okay. Jesus Christ position. Like this, okay. Okay, excellent. Now here take precaution that you don't overstretch. Okay, let it be very relaxed, relaxed position. Yes, very relaxed, very relaxed. Haath upar karo thoda, paon mein distance, paon ki distance bhul gaye. Theek hai? Up to shoulder level, okay, like this. Excellent, and visualize that you have a big balloon in your hand and you have expanded it so much. Okay, and then thereafter start compressing it. Just compress up to here. Downwards and sink. Again rise and open out. Okay, compress and sink. Rise, open out, compress, sink. Now when you sink, you know, let the hands go beyond this. Don't stop it here. Okay, let the hands go here. Again rise, open out, compress and sink. Rise, open out, compress and sink. Rise, open out, compress, sink. All right? Okay, understood where this way? Yeah.
When you raise the arm,
yeah. Correct. Yes, you should be rising. So when you start raising your hands, okay, no resonance, okay, this level no resonance. If you want to ask the questions, you come forward so that you don't give resonance to the system. All right. So, you know, it's like this, you're rising also and you're raising your hands. So when you go in this position, you're virtually upright, standing, and then start expanding. So even in the first moment also, rising and raising, raising the arms and knee straight, you know, they have to be simultaneous. All right, by practice you will come to that, you know, initially there is a backlash kind of thing. Thoda sa survatila ti problem asto, because there are too many things to do. Apply mind, apan ajun breathing par nalelot nahiye. When we come to breathing, then you will know how interestingly the moment can be. All right. So, malat thoda ajun ite he freeness nahi milat hai to. You know, they cannot. Yeah, come this side still. Okay. Because I want you to enjoy that moment to such an extent. Kurcha bhai ta 8 taka. Ta ekat ek stack kara kurcha. You will get more space. Absolutely, it's a perfect thing. It is derived from martial arts. The movements are martial arts movements, but martial art movement is primarily, you know, concentration and focus and punch. But if I give you a simple example, I will show you how Tai Chi movements can be, you know, interesting. You know, as far as, okay, now you hold my, try to hold my neck like this. Okay, now my first movement is what? No, raising the arms. So I hit you here, okay? This is martial art movement, hit you here, then I put your hand here and I punch. Okay. So that becomes, but now interestingly, when you do it slowly, you know, it's simple like this. Raise the hands and then push and then punch. Once you do that, you know, your chi flow eventually flows like that, and it's a very soft form, you know. It doesn't give you any exertion. After you do Tai Chi, Shibashi for 20 minutes, 25 minutes regularly, all the 18 movements, you can burn about 300 calories. It's as good as walking for an hour with 3.5 kilometers distance. When you have a full focus, when you have a full involvement, when you do go through all the six stages, it will start burning 300 calories. Take it from me. So eventually it will give you emotional control when you sit to eat something when required and when not required. Okay, emotional control. Sometimes, you know, we want to pamper ourselves. TV dekhta hai to thoda jara muh mein kuch chahiye, excess calories. Okay, hota hai, it's natural thing, but it will give you that control. Nahi, thoda wrong time hai, maybe later. Let the system gives me a signal that I am hungry rather than my mind. Okay, when it does that, then you eat only that much what is required, consume only that much what is required, you know. And you know, this is how you are. Is very good, effective in weight management program. Tai Chi is very good in weight management program. All right, but burning calories also. I don't know how many people are sweating, but I am sweating. You are sweating. How much? What we have done? Nothing. We are just. But even though you are sweating, you are not tired. Most important. So even though the sweat is, the calories are being burned, you are not exhausted, your stamina is not going down. On the contrary, you would like to do something more. And that is the beauty of Tai Chi and Shibashi and everything. All right?
Yeah, yeah.
Pardon?
You don't want to lose weight.
Okay. Balance your calories. If you are burning more than required, then balance it out. Eat more. As simple as that. Have some chocolate or have some this thing. You know, there are varieties of items, though look small, can give you fantastic calories. The fruits, they give you the less calories, you know, even though they look big. Okay, so balance it out. It gives you let's an insight how you can take care of your requirement, your health. Okay, I don't know how many people, the book is not yet circulated here. You have it. Now there is a very interesting articles in the books. Now read the book regularly. How to bring Tai Chi into your life and how, you know, useful for your body and diet and things like that. A lot of things are given in the book. Use it as a inside out. Yeah, this is the book I am talking about. This is written by my grandmaster called Gary Kaur, who is in Australia. Okay, I am a certified trainer of this. This book is available through Carlton sir. It's a fantastic book, fundamental book. It gives you all insight about what Tai Chi is, including the Shibashi form. So anyone who would love to make a beginning, you know, Shibashi, start with Shibashi. Once you are comfortable, once you are directing the basics of practicing Tai Chi, to the portal WebMD. WebMD. I will give you the WebMD. Now, where each and every deficiency in the body, deficiency, diseases, symptoms, the causes, the remedies, everything is given there. So the end results might be showing, but arthritis could be of different types, different things. The causes may be different. Okay, we have to understand. That is what normally, generally, the doctor does the job. You know, the diagnostic by various tests and test results and things like that. All right. So shall we go for the third one now? Okay. Now third one is very interesting. Now this second one is called broadening the chest or expanding the chest. This is the longest breathing cycle. It gives you something like 10 seconds breathing cycle, like this. In one breathing cycle, you are completing this movement. All right. Now here, our home position is here again. All right. We have come to this level now. Start raising your hands. Okay, facing each other. Up. All right. Now transfer your weight on one leg. Just one leg. All right. Left or right. Okay. So if you have transferred your weight on left leg, take your right arm out like this, shoulder height. Okay. And this hand, put it on top of it. Just like that. All right. So this is one posture. Slowly transfer your weight on the other leg and this. So what happens is, one leg is bent, the other leg is straight. See here, the other leg is completely straight like this. Okay, this movement is called painting a rainbow. The visualization is like there is a wonderful rainbow in front of your eyes and you have a brush and you are just painting the rainbow very slowly like that. Okay.
This year, after the practice, you have to close the eye and do it.
Not necessarily.
Your visualization will be better.
No, it depends on what you want to visualize. Visualization is in our hand. Okay.
Rainbow, I mean.
Yeah, rainbow, but then if you close your eyes, how it will assist you in this thing? Visualization, you can still, it's a matter of practice. When you close your eyes, let me put it this way. Eyes is one of the sensor to give you the control over balance. Okay, how person loses a balance. All right, there are many people you will see standing on one leg, for hours and hours and hours. But try to do the same thing by closing your eyes. You can't do it for a few seconds because that is one of the sensor. Your ear, eyes, your body balance, your limbs, it gives you, I am in a balanced position. Okay? You lose the balance position moment you close your eyes. Unless you are totally fully balanced and still you want to. But herein what happens is, people who are having a problem with say high blood pressure or thing like that, you know, they should not close the eyes. Okay? Suddenly you will have a, you know, giddiness. So why ask for trouble when it is not required? Visualization will come on its own. Okay, let's understand the form. Okay, all right. Okay, so here it is called like this. Transfer your weight like here. Sir ji, okay, aap chalu rakho. One hand here like this, and one here like this. Okay, then. Like this. Okay. Like this. Excellent.
Keep your body.
Like this.
Only move your arms.
Only move your arms. Beautiful. You are doing wonderful. Yes. Correct. Perfect. Perfect.
You have to look to watch.
Yes. Visualize. like this. So it gives you exercise to your eyes also. Because your upper body is not turned at all straight. See, only eyes and my legs. See here, like this. I'm not even bending in my, you know, no bend in here, like this. No, you know, it just like this. Eyes follow like this. To practice this moment, initially practice what we call as the leg movements. Leg movements are like this. Transfer your weight here. Okay, by transferring weight, my one knee is bent and the other one is straight. Again, here. Alright. Again here. This movement you can do again by taking support of a chair. People who can't, you know, do. Because here, what you are doing is transferring your center of gravity, balance towards left. And to balance it out, because you are off balance, to balance it out, you are putting your right hand here. So your center of gravity gets shifted again to the middle of the body. Alright. Yeah, you don't do it. You don't. No. I understand. Eventually we'll find when you start doing this, your weaker limb will start gaining the chi from your stronger limbs. Watch my word. Yes. Depends on you again. See here, when I say I'm looking at the tip of my foot here, okay, then I'm transferring. Now I'm not looking like this, okay, but I'm following. It's like, you know, when through our eyesight, you know, you'll find, you know, there's a big picture. I'm sorry, the big, no, I'm too short. Too short, don't worry. You know, you'll find, you know, even if you're looking here, I can see her movement. I can see her movement. You are given, you know, that angle of vision is very large. So you need not go virtually like this. But, you know, you can, when what he said as a visualization, you know, you can virtually go like this. But still, rainbow can be in front of your eyes also here. Okay. Like this. Like this. It gives exercise to your eyes also, along with the neck. Okay, your neck is also moving, your eyes are also moving. Okay, what you enjoy most is important. there is no hardcore perfect form. Mind well, keep that in mind. Whatever you enjoy, but you understand the basic nature of the form, then you derive your own form. All right. Excellent.
Sir, the leg is straight but not locked.
Not locked. You know, there is no weight on that leg. You see, I'm transferring my weight. See here, there is nothing here. It's weightless. Only as a fulcrum, as a support kind of thing. You know, just okay. I'm not standing virtually on one leg. Okay. Then, you know, at the moment will become like this. No. All right. It is, idea here is you are transferring the weight on one side. So the entire weight is shifted here. To stop falling, you are balancing it out like this. Okay. Like, you know, people while walking, some people they take a stick. It doesn't mean that they are putting the entire weight on the stick. It is just a feeler. It's just a feeler. All right. Okay. One more, okay. No, I don't mind. I have no issue on that. I can go for next.
Can we do one more? Should we do one more? One more?
No, the fifth one is very difficult.
We'll try to get it.
It requires one session. The fifth moment in this requires one complete session. It's that thing. Anyway, fine. So, okay, I'll ask a question. What was the first moment? Excellent, good. And the next one? Expanding the chest, broadening the chest. And the third one? Painting the rainbow. और क्या चाहिए? घर जाके यही practice करने का है. बस और कुछ नहीं है, ठीक है? अभी In the third movement, you know, we are like this, and then we are like this, and sometime we are like this. Okay? So this is our home position for the fourth movement. So ek bar aise aa gaye haath, to aista aista aista. Abhi kya visualize karna hai? Ki bhai yahan upar mein bahut sare badal jama hue hain. Haan, badal hai. You know, there are all lot of clouds over your head, and they are slowly and gently we are separating them. So we are just separating them like this. Alright? And then once you come down, you cross your hands and again rise. And then again separate the clouds and bring them down. Beauty. Kitna maza aa raha hai, dekho. Floating karke niche aa rahe hai hum log. Aram se. Wow. Good. Good. Okay. Asaan hai na ekdam? Shibashi is very easy. Very easy to learn, easy to understand, easy to practice, easy to follow, and sometime later easy to teach also. So you keep that target, that you are not learning for yourself, but someday you are going to teach somebody else, either in the family or in the neighborhood or the community or thing like that. And imagine, you know, when you start teaching in the neighborhood, people will come and ask you, aapne ye kahan sikha? Kitni aasani se kar rahi hai aap? Aur itne has rahi hai aap? And that is the beauty of it. All right. छोड़ो, अंदर बाहर कुछ भी चलेगा. ठीक है, all well, everything fine, good, cheers, good, good.
Do the full 18 and show them.
Oh yes, yes, yes.
Okay. So what we will do now? We'll ask Sunil sir to do all the 18, so you can see how the flow is.
How the flow is? Yes, 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 yes. Yeah. Take your seats.
Ask him to demonstrate.
Yeah, 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 yeah. Sure, sure.
Please be seated.
Can I have my music along with that?
My.
No problem. Hey, music let him. Hey, music let him.
Okay, I'll settle.